It is now day two of Iceland's latest eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, and boy, a lot happened during the night. First, right after I stated that there were no ash emissions to be expected because the existing fissure was not cutting through any subglacial vents or ash layers which could hold abundant water, I was suddenly proven wrong when minor ash emissions started being emitted from a point source. This began around 2 a.m. local time last night, creating periods of weak but sustained ash emissions which rose to between 100 and 1,000 meters elevation. I geolocated these weak ash emissions to be from the rim of what appears to be a several thousand year old tuff ring, which was the only source of ash so far. However, ash emissions are still minuscule enough and remaining close to the ground that any disruptions to air traffic are quite unlikely. The second thing to mention is that overnight, the erupting fissure slowly expanded to the north, nearly doubling in length from 4 to 7 kilometers long. This fissure expansion was preceded by nearly 50 magnitude 2 range earthquakes and 1 magnitude 4.2 earthquake, which in of themselves signaled magma reaching such shallow depths that they forced apart overlying rock in areas where this had not happened in more than 750 years. These earthquakes occurred in three clusters, moving further north-northeastward as time progressed, although they have largely stopped, meaning further fissure expansion from the magma dike is unlikely. I want to note that one cluster of earthquakes struck along a northwest-facing trend contrary to the other two regions, and I believe that these quakes were generated by strain placed on a previously unknown minor fault in the area. As expected, the initial eruptive rate has declined by over 90%, as you can see via this image series. Currently, only 5.6% of the original 7-kilometer fissure is still visibly producing lava fountains, and it appears that the southern of these two is currently the dominant vent. In other words, this segment is likely to build a spatter cone once the northern fissure ceases its activity. Despite the drastic decline in activity, lava is still erupting at a rate upwards of 25 cubic meters per second, causing the existing lava field to continue growing. Wall lava spread across 3 square kilometers of ground during the first 2 hours of this latest eruption. As of 20 hours later, it has surpassed all post-2015 Icelandic lava fields, reaching what I estimate to be an area of 13.17 square kilometers or 5.08 square miles. I want to admit that this figure could be an overestimate, but I am sure that at least 10 square kilometers have been covered by a layer of lava so far. The northern lobe of lava is still advancing to the north, but in my opinion is quite unlikely to travel all 4,300 meters to reach the main road there. What is likely, however, is that the southern of the two fissures will cause the lava flow's western lobe to flow over a previously unaffected section of paved road, being only 275 meters away from accomplishing this. I am quite glad that lava flows are not threatening Grindavik, have so far not damaged any structures during the current eruption, and appear unlikely to damage anything apart from maybe one paved road. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Donald Saunders for supporting this YouTube channel.